Hello everybody and welcome to our presentation about Axmann's Data Quality Assurance Tool, checkgeodata.net. My name is Thomas Galka. I am service engineer at Axmann GeoInformation based in Vienna. I am certified FME desktop and server professional and trainer, and I am working with FME already for more than 10 years right now. In my presentation, I will mainly talk about data and data quality assurance. I will show you the current situation at many companies today and how they struggle data quality issues and how our tool checkgeodata.net can help them out. I will show you the kind of checks our tool is providing, and we'll show you in a short demo the functionality of CheckGeodata, like the delivery function, for example. Okay, so let's begin and let us talk about CheckGeodata.net and data quality assurance. But why do we need data at all? Well, actually, we don't need data for the sake of itself, but we need the information that is stored in the data, because we need information for making decisions. We need information for making decisions in our daily life, as well as business decisions. And today, we produce a huge amount of data. We produce them almost anytime just by using our smartphone or pursuing our daily business. And you probably know that some of the biggest companies in the world, like Google or Facebook, are earning their money by using our data. And this is why the data is the gold of the 21st century. But the information that is stored in the data is quite raw and lack any meanings at the beginning. And so you need to perform some intensive and complex data analysis procedures to extract some facts from the data and put them into a proper logical context. That means that without data, you are not able to make any business decisions. So if your data is clean and correct, you are lucky and you can make good decisions for your business. But unfortunately, it's almost always not the case, and you are dealing with bad data, and so you are almost doomed to make bad decisions because of that. Because when your data is poor, incorrect, incomplete, and unreliable, the consequences can be quite damaging for your business. Why? Some researchers found out that the cost of bad data is up to 25% of the revenue for the most companies. As you can see, a very huge amount, and the companies are hiring very skilled and specialized workers like data analysts, data scientists, data engineers to work with data. And those qualified employees are wasting up to 80% of their working time just by dealing with data quality issues. And this is because many companies still don't have any existing quality assurance plan. That means that a big variety of very different data from many different sources reaches the company by undefined and undocumented pathways. In the worst case, just as an email attachment to a specific person. Yeah, and those persons become overstrained because it's up to them to ensure that only correct and clean data is added to the company, the production systems. And because they are only humans, it's not always possible. And so erroneous data is added to the company systems, and that results in system errors. Some automated processes based on that data fail, and the data becomes unusable for any further processing. In other words, that means nothing else than deprecation of your precious data. So, and this is how it looks like. We have the data vendor here who produces the data, and he sends the data he has produced to a company. That means he sends it to a data clerk working for that company. And now it's up to that guy here to ensure that only clean and correct data will be imported into the company production systems. So he has to take a deep look on the data. He must check it. And if it's not correct, and this is almost always the case, he has to send the data back to the data vendor and communicate with him, tell him what's wrong, and ask him to correct the data. Then the data vendor must follow the instructions by the data clerk, and he must correct the data and send him the data back again. And this process here is repeated as many times until the data clerk finally gives up. Sorry, of course, I mean after the data clerk finally gets correct data that he can import to the company production system and hope that everything will be okay. Well, and that's the moment where CheckGeodata comes to play. So what is CheckGeodata? CheckGeodata.net is Axmann's online tool for data quality assurance based on FME technology. So the data holders define their specifications of their data, and we set up workspaces for them checking if these requirements are fulfilled or not. The workspaces are uploaded and automated on FME server hosted by us, and the FME server processes are connected to our application via REST API. So the users can connect to their check routines using the web interface. Now the data process is fully automated. The data creator chooses the specification, uploads his data, sets some parameters and check. If the data is not correct, he can download an error report and an error file where the errors are located, and so he can easily correct them and make that process again. After the data is correct, he will be informed and he will receive a check certificate, and now using the delivery function, he can send the data and the check certificate directly to the data receiver. And this is how the FME workspace looks like. Here you can see the input data that is generic, so many different formats are possible. Here you see a lot of custom transformers containing the check routines. That means each data specification is a check routine, and each check routine is embedded in a separate custom transformer. Here in that part of the workspace, the error features get some post-processing before, depending on the input format, the user can receive the error file of the same format, and depending if the data is correct or not, he can receive a PDF error log file or a PDF check certificate. So what kind of checks we can provide by checkgeodata.net? Well, because it's based on FME, there are almost no limitations regarding this. So usually we check the schema, if the attribute names and layer names are correct. We check the attribute values, do they have the correct range, are they from the correct data type. We check geometries, are there any geometry errors like the self-intersections or something like that. We check if the geometry types fit the feature types. For some formats also we can check the appearance, like AutoCAD block definitions, like color, size, etc. And it's going up to complex topology tests and checks of special relations between objects. And of course, anything the customer wants to have, and we can set up on FME workspace. And this is how the user interface looks like. The user chooses the check routine he is permitted for. He uploads the data he wants to check and just push the button for checking. Then he waits a few moments, and after the check is done, and if the data is correct, he is free to use the check geodata delivery functionality to send the data directly to the data receiver, together with some additional files like delivery slips, bills, descriptions, etc., and so ensuring the integrity between data and certificate. Almost the same workflow here. He gives a name for the delivery, he chooses his delivery contact, adds some files if he like, and push the button for sending. At the same time, our data clerk receives an email telling him that there is some data delivery waiting for him, and now it's up to him to confirm that delivery or send the data back to the creator. Okay, let's see how check geodata looks like in the real life. Therefore, I already opened my browser. You can see I'm already logged in with my user. I choose the routine. I upload the data I want to check. I choose some additional parameters related to that check routine and start checking. After a few moments, the check is done and I can find the process in my check archive, and I see there are 12 errors in my file, so I can download the error log file to take a look at that errors, and in the same way I can download the error file and overlay it with my original data you can see here. And that allows me to see where the errors are located. And now it's easily for me to correct the data and check again. So after the data is corrected, I make the same check procedure, choose the parameters, start checking, and happily to see the data is correct now, and I can use the delivery functionality to deliver the data directly to the data receiver. I can add some additional data. I choose my delivery contact. I start to deliver. And I see in my delivery archive that I have delivered this data here, but the data has not been confirmed yet. At the same time, the data clerk receives an email and he can find the data delivery in his incoming delivery. And now it's up to him to accept the delivery or reject it. If it's accepted, the data creator can find in his delivery archive that his delivery has been confirmed. And so it's done for him, and also it's for the data clerk. So, as you have seen, data is very important today, and so data quality assurance is even more important, but still a time-intensive procedure. But thanks to Axmann's checkgeodata.net, you can use now an automated data quality tool and bring order to your data chaos from the very beginning when the data ingests your company systems. And now we are finished with the presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. We are still here to answer your questions in the chat. And if you want to know anything else, do not hesitate us to write us an email. So wish you a nice day and hope to hear from you soon.